got a good haul. No freighters, no jobs, no contracts in weeks. We're standing around kicking rocks.
What's the word? Not surprised. Trask was a dead man trying to negotiate with his own executioner. He'd say anything to preserve his life. That's a damning accusation. Am I right to presume you have some evidence on hand? Those papers don't prove a thing. We've all done business with the board. They own the whole damn colony. Trask put you up to this. That miserable wretch. He's trying to undermine everything I stand for. You've got a lot of nerve calling me a liar to my face. How should I know? What the hell do I care? Trask was a traitor. I didn't ask you to understand his motives. I asked you to cross him off.
Clyde, look me in the eye and tell me it's not true. Tell me, and I'll believe you.
Don't talk to me like I'm some common criminal, Felix. You're the one on trial, not me. I don't know what kind of poison that snake dripped in your ear, but as far as I'm concerned, you've been compromised.
Watch out!
about to ruin your day.
You're mine.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship.
You're adjusting before you call. You're anticipating.
This is definitely not how I imagined it'd end. The void's black, water's wet, and Clyde hated the board. That's something I just knew. Now? I don't know. I don't know what to think. No. I guess you really don't. I've just got a lot on my mind right now. This is a lot to take in. I always looked up to Clyde. The thought that he could be an agent of the board is just abhorrent to me. Yeah, he did. And I'm not sure how I'm gonna get over that. I hope so. I don't see this one passing anytime soon. You've given me a lot to think about. I'm gonna be mulling over this whole mess for a couple of days. Part of me wishes we'd put Trask in the ground. You know, I think that's just my frustration talking. Thanks for your time, boss.
Destination reached. Scylla.
cars!
This'll be fun.
System. Searching for unauthorized.
This might be tough.
You are in for it now.
Thank you.
Greetings, Junior Excavator. Greetings, Junior Excavator.
That queen ain't gonna go down easy. I can't wait. What's up? What's up? Outstanding. These ought to be enough. Let's get back to Monarch. There's an old base I used to call home. I can get us in the door, but we'll have to shoot our way through the Queen's brood to get to the center. We'll set the bait there. Password to the door is Charon. Hayes' idea. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, Nyoka, Charon. He said it was some old myth, something about death and all the things we killed. Rest of us just thought it sounded cool, so here we are. It's an old cave system we tried to turn into an encampment. You'll see when we get there.
A reminder to all crew members, there is only one toilet on the ship. We are now in orbit above Stellar Bay, Captain. No blockade is a match for my piloting skills.
Something else I can do for you?
Thank you. You ever think about what goes on in a marauder's head?
here we go. I haven't set foot in here since... Well, I'm ready. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Here we go.
Well, this is the spot. You know, I thought I'd be angry. I thought I'd storm in here in a rage and exterminate all these bugs and everything would be all right in the end. But I ain't. I'm mostly just empty. A little sad, maybe. The first night Hayes and I spent in here, we knew it was home. It's safe. It's got a nice chill to it. But mostly, it doesn't stink of sulfur. Monarch folks often joke about it. Not because of the smell or the grittiness it leaves in your throat. Not because of the headaches or the coughing. It's because there's no escaping it. It's life here, and there ain't anything you can do about it. But here, somehow the sulfur never made it. The nights we spent in here felt like vacations. So we started building. We hauled in steel. Hired sublight folk to help. That's how we met Anders and Opal. They stuck around after our contract was up. Opal liked camping. Anders liked chasing her tail. Four of us for a while, scraping together what bits we could to build our home. Then came Rebecca, a sawbones out of the Cascadia survivors, who took a kindness to Hayes. And Clara, her little sister. I'll admit I wasn't keen on taking her on at first. But for a teenager, she was surprisingly capable. She had a head for numbers, helped us trade hides for food and materials, negotiated contracts, turned out to be mighty useful. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, and me. Six folks, one name, one family, Charon. Despite Monarch trying to kill us day in and day out, we managed to belong. Me too, Captain. But I'm starting to think that maybe I've found another. Now let's get to shooting before I get all sentimental.
Get ready!
I wish these were more auspicious circumstances, but at least we're all here. This bringing them together, burying them. This is the kind of thing Hayes would have done. That makes it stupid. By all accounts, we should have left well enough alone, but that also makes it right. Captain, thank you. You mind if we rest a spell before we head out? I'd like to bury Opal and Clara proper before I lay everyone's medallions to rest. What? Why? Them's painful memories, Captain. Huh. That ain't a bad point. All right, Captain. Thanks.
great work.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship.
You're adjusting before you pull. You're anticipating.
Of course I'm anticipating it. What if I shoot a friend on accident?
On account of your stance, you want to lean into it. Embrace it. Work.
Something else I can do for you?
Hey, Kev.
Knock, knock.
always imagined Fallbrook would be...
What do you want?
Oh, hey, Vicar Max. What are you doing on Monarch? I thought scienticians ain't welcome here.
Haven't you heard? Everyone's welcome here. It's a fucking worker's paradise. But you wouldn't know anything about that, would you? Never worked a day in your miserable life. You're just a parasite, living off my goodwill. Well, guess what? My goodwill's exhausted, along with my temper. This is the guy who told me about the book while we were in prison. I lied about finding a scholar. But I don't care about any of that anymore. I just want to inflict massive amounts of pain on this guy. Oh, he knew. Didn't you? Didn't you?
Okay, I admit it. I was tired of your high and mighty speechifying all the time. It was just a joke, I swear. I didn't mean nothing by it.
See, Captain? I've dealt with this swine before. I know how he thinks. Now, where were we? Oh, that's right. I was about to beat you. Severely.
Wait! I know who can translate the book for you.
It's too late for that. I threw away my life chasing fairy tales. Will punishing you fix any of that? Of course not. But by law, it will make me feel a whole lot better. Okay. Talk, Reggie.
It was stolen from some sort of expert on philosophism. Weird hermit lady on Scylla. My father used to deliver supplies to the mining outpost there. It's true. My father collected some extra bits on the side by diverting some of the supplies to the gal. The way he told it, he thought the book looked valuable, so he took it. Couldn't find any buyers when it turned out to not only be French, but banned as well.
Fine. We've got more important things to do anyway.
Captain, Felix and the Vicar are arguing again.
You don't think that's a problem? Whole ship's running on a computer's fancy. That'll make you nervous, Preacher?
No, Felix. The concept of a ship computer does not make me nervous. Are you scared of Ada?
I ain't scared of Ada.
Good. I'm glad we cleared that up.
It's just, she's a computer, Max. What happens when her equations tell her to cut off her oxygen? Or blast us all into space?
Felix, Ada is not sentient. She can't act out of a sense of malice. Where do you get these ideas?
I was watching True Stories of Mechanical Murderers last night.
One of these days I'm going to make you read an actual book. Captain, I was hoping for a word.
I want to thank you for talking some sense into me back there with Chaney.
It has been a long time since I gave in to my violent enthusiasm.
You're right. I owe you an apology. I've been so obsessed for so long, I couldn't see anything else. You offered me a place on your crew, friendship, and I used you to get to Chaney. And even then, you saved me from myself. I don't know if I could live with myself had I gone through with it. You owe me nothing, I know, but I'm begging your forgiveness. Thank you. I promise I'll be nothing but truthful from this point forward. Oh, exactly as you'd imagine. Can't say I enjoyed the stint. It did provide me with plenty of time to think. The way I see it, the universe was snapping me back to where I needed to be. You stray too far from the course of your destiny, the world will try to correct for it.